chapter 4, the first law of money. Algamish gave me a piercing look from under his shaggy eyebrows and said these words in a low and forceful tone. I found the road to wealth when I decided that a part of all I earned was mine to keep, and so will you. I was waiting for more, but there was none. So with raised eyebrows, I asked in disbelief, "Is that all?" That was enough to change the heart of a sheep herder into the heart of a rich moneyed lender, he replied, referring to himself. All too confused, I retorted, "But all I earn is mine to keep, is it not?" He said in a mocking voice, "Far from it. Let me ask you, do you not pay the garment maker? Do you not pay the sandal maker? Do you not pay the food vendor? Can you live in Babylon without spending? You fool, you pay everyone but yourself. You work for others. You are no better than a slave who works and just waits for his master to give him food and clothing. But you can be more than that. You can be in control." I was trying hard to understand what Algamish was saying when he asked me two questions. "Tell me, what have you to show for all the years you've been working? If you only kept 1/4 of all you earned, how much would you have in 10 years? Then I realized that I didn't have anything to show for all the hard work I've done. To answer the second question, I recalled our lessons in numbers under our master and I answered, "As much as I earn in 1 year?" Algamish said, "You're right, but that's only half of the story. And you may ask why. It's because for every piece of gold you save, it's your slave to work for you. Every copper it earns is a child that can also earn for you. For you to become rich, what you save must earn, and its children must earn, that all may help to give you the abundance that you dream of." He went on, "Can you see the tree out there? Wealth is just like that tree. It grows from a tiny seed. The first copper you save is the seed from which your tree of wealth shall grow. The sooner you plant that seed, the sooner the tree grows. And the more faithfully you nourish and water the tree with continuous savings, the sooner you may bask in the contentment under its shade." Algamish looked me in the eye to make sure I understood the first law of money. Pay yourself first. It should not be less than 1/10, no matter how little you earn. It can be as much as you can afford. Do not buy from the clothes maker, the sandal maker, and all the other vendors more than you can afford, and you will find out that you have enough for your needs and charity. After saying this, Algamish took his tablet and went away. Arkad gave his friends time to understand the first law of money. Then he continued his story.